Hey, Great Bridge UMC. I'm Cheryl Pearson, and I want to welcome you to day 26 of our Lenten scripture reading. Go ahead and make sure you have your caterpillars handy. And we're going to be reading today from the Gospel of John, chapter 15, verses 1 through 27. Let's read together. I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain in me as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine and you are the branches. If you remain in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like the branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. As my Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and I remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, than to lay down one's life for a friend. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last. So that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love each other. If the world hates you, remember that it hated me first. If you belonged to the world, it would love you as its own. But you do not belong to the world. I have chosen you out of the world. That is why the world hates you. Remember what I told you: a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they obeyed my teaching, they will obey yours as well. They will treat you this way because of my name, for they do not know the one who sent me. If I had come and spoken to them, they would not be guilty of sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. Whoever hates me hates my Father as well. If I had not done among them the works that no one else did, they would not be guilty of sin. As it is, they have seen, and yet they have hated both me and my Father. But this is to fulfill what is written in their law: they hated me for no reason. When the Advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who goes out from the Father, he will tell you about me. And you must also tell others, for you have been with me from the beginning. Boys and girls, this scripture passage today is one of my absolute favorites. The verse that I specifically love is John chapter 15, verse 5. It says, "I am the vine and you are the branches. If you remain in me and I remain in you, then you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing." The reason I love this Bible verse so much is because it reminds me that we have to stay close to God in order to do anything. Boys and girls, God created us so that we are able to live in relationship with Him. The way that we do that is through Jesus. If you imagine a tree that grows apples, think of that apple. It's growing and it's getting all of its nutrients from the tree, isn't it? What happens when that apple falls off of the tree? Imagine you see one sitting on the ground right next to the tree that it belonged to. What if you watched it for a few days? What's going to happen? That apple is going to turn brown. It's going to start going rotten, isn't it? And it's because that apple is no longer attached to the tree that provides life. This scripture passage tells us that we are the branches. If we don't stay connected to the life-giving tree, then we're also going to die. We're going to break and fall off and be rotten. In order to stay alive and to bear fruit, to grow fruit in our lives, we have to remain in Jesus. Boys and girls, when this scripture passage is talking about fruit, it's not talking about apples and oranges. It's talking about the fruit of the Spirit, which is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. If we remain in Jesus, boys and girls, Jesus is going to create fruit in us. He's going to change our hearts and change our lives so that the fruit that we put out is good fruit. If we are not connected to Jesus, then we are not going to produce love or joy or peace or patience or kindness. We can't do that without Jesus. Jesus says in this Bible passage, just as the Father has loved Jesus, Jesus loves us. He tells us to remain in his love so that we can go out and bear fruit to the world. God gives us the command to love one another as he has loved us. And he loved us so much, boys and girls, that he laid down his life. He died because he loved us so very much. And boys and girls, even if you were the only person on earth, the only one, Jesus still would have died for just you and you alone because he loves you that much. Jesus knew that we could not be with the Father on our own. We must remain in Jesus. He is the vine, we are the branches. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through him. Let's pray together. Dear God, we thank you that this Bible verse reminds us that if we want to bear fruit of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, then we need to remain in Jesus because he is the vine, we are the branches, and apart from him, we can do nothing. We cannot grow on our own, but we need Jesus. We need the Holy Spirit to be with us and to help us to grow in you. And dear Lord, we pray that every single day we will remain in you when we wake up in the morning and when we go to sleep at night. We love you, God, and we thank you for loving us so much that you gave your only son to die for us so that we might know you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you, boys and girls, for joining me, and I'll see you tomorrow. Tomorrow's Saturday, but we will join together for day 27 of our Lenten scripture reading. See you later.